Hi friends, welcome to ISOP tutorials. In today's lesson, we will discuss about non-restoring division method used for binary division. In my previous video, I have explained about restoring division method. Just have a look on it and practice it so that you can understand non-restoring division method very well. You can find my video link in the above information icon. For this method, we will use this algorithm. So in this algorithm, you can see that there are two steps. In previous algorithm, there is only one step that we are performing n number of times. Here, there are two steps, step 1 and step 2. Step 1, we will perform n number of times. Step 2 is after this n iterations, we will perform step 2. So we will go step by step. In first step, do n number of times. What we have to perform? Step A and step B. Or substep A and substep B. In step A, if we will check first sine of A is 0. Before shifting, we are checking sine of A is 0. In previous method, that is restoring division method, we have checked that first we have shifted A and Q, and then we have checked all these things. But here, before shifting, we have to check that if sine of A is 0 before shifting, then shift A and Q left and subtract m from a, that is a equals to a minus m. Else if sine of a is 1, then shift a and q left and add m to a, that is a is equals to a plus m. Here if you observe, if sine of a is 0, then we are performing shifting and a minus m, a equals to a minus m. If sine of a is 1, then shifting and a equals to a plus n, m we will perform. Then after performing this, after deciding steps and solving for a equals to a minus m and a equals to a plus m, we will check for if sine of a is 0 after this result, a is equals to a minus m, or we have selected about for a is equals to a plus m. If after this result, if sine of a is 0, then set q0 to 1. After this result or this result, if sine of a is 0, set q0 to 1. Else if sine of a is 1, then set q0 to 0. Only in step B we are checking sine after result of a, and if it is 0, set q0 to 1. If it is 1, then set q0 to 0. We will not perform any restoring here, hence it is called as non-restoring division method. In step number 2, after n iteration, that is we will repeat A and B these steps, and after n iteration we will perform step number 2. If sine of A is 1, then add m back to A. So here we have to restore the result. This is nothing concerned with this restoring method, non-restoring method. If sine of A is 1, a plus m we have to perform, that is A equals to A plus m. This is for getting back the result from negative result. So this step we will perform at last after calculating n iterations, and we will get some result if a is negative. So we will perform a plus m to make it positive. Here we will consider this example 1000 divided by 118 divided by 3 in binary. So here again three register we will consider, m, a and q. M is set to 11, so we will write here 11. Q is set to 1000, 4 number of bits. So for M, we have to adjust these bits, so we will add 2 bits here, 0011, and we will also add one extra bit. For performing this algorithm, we will add extra bit just as we have done for restoring division method. So 3 zeros, 1 1. In A, in this A we will add only, we will consider 0. So 5 zeros. For performing A plus M and A minus M, we have to adjust this bit. So here we have considered 4 bits plus 1, that is 5 bits. So here we will consider 5 number of zeros. So M, A and Q are set accordingly. This is our initial stage. Now we will move to algorithm and we will solve these steps. So in algorithm, we have seen that step number one, we will perform n number of times. So before shifting, we'll check sine of A is 0 or 1. So here sine of A is 0. Which step we will select? If sine of A is 0, then we will perform A and Q shifting to left and A minus M is stored back in A. That is A equals to A minus M. So here you can see that sine of A is 0. Hence we will select this step. So here if sine of A is 0, shift A and Q left and A equals to A minus M. So we will perform this in our method, we will apply this method in our example. So first check this bit sine of A is 0. So the steps are, I will write here first steps, shift, then subtract. If sine of A is 0, steps are shift, subtract. If sine of A is 1, shift, add. So here we will perform this step, shift A and Q to left, so empty space, then 0, this 0 will be shifted here, then again 0, 3 zeros, and then 1 will be shifted at last bit of or LSB bit of A. So 1 and all zeros, if you perform shifting, you will get this one as 3 times or 5, 4 times 0, 1 and 3 times 0, empty space. We have to fill up this empty space. So what step we have selected? Subtract M from A. So we have to find 2's complement of M. 2's complement of M will be 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. In our last method also we have discussed about this. We have to find 2's complement of M. So I will write here 2's complement of M, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1 and add it to the A. 1 plus 1, 0, carry 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So 4 times 1 and 0 we got. So we will check this last bit in our algorithm. Again, if you see after performing this, now if second bit is B, if sine of A is 0, we have selected this one first, if sine of A is 0, then if sine of A is 0, after performing this first step, if sine of A is 0, set Q0 to 1, if sine of A is 1, set Q0 to 0. Here we got this sine bit as 1, so we will select this one, else if sine of A is 1, set Q0 to 0. So here we will set this Q0 as 0. I will write it here 0, 0, 0 and this empty box will be set as 0 because here we got sine as of A as 1 after performing first step. So these 2 steps we have to repeat again and again. So this is first iteration I will consider. I will write here first cycle or first iteration. How many iterations are there? N iteration. N value, that is number of bits, are 4. So we will get 4 iteration. Again before shifting we will check for the sine bit of A. So sine bit of A is 1. So our steps are, if sine bit of A is 1, shift and. So we will perform addition of A and M. So instead of 2's complement, now we will use 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. So for this, I will write here 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. Perform this addition, we will get it as 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. No carry generated from anywhere. So we will simply get 1, 1, 1, 5 times 1. Then remaining is set Q0. I will rewrite here Q and here we have to update this last bit. So we will check this sine bit again of A. If sine of A is 1 after the result, then we will set again it as 0 just as in previous step. We will mark it as step number 2. Again step will be repeated. So we will check for the sine bit. Sine bit is 1. So the steps are shift, add and set Q0. These 3 steps we have to perform for this sine bit as 1. So we will add this A and M and first we will shift it. So updated values we will shift, empty space, 0, 0, 0, this 0 will be LSB. Then 1, 1, 1, 1, 4 times 1 and 0. This is our A value. We will add M to A. Addition, for addition we will perform this 0, 0, 1, 1, perform addition. Just as in previous step we have done, so I am considering it that you can do it fast. So 1, 1, 0, carry 1, 0, carry 1, 0, carry 1, 0. 4 times 0 we got, and then 1. We have to update Q0. In set Q0 step, we will update Q0. I will rewrite it again. So after rewriting, we will get Q as 000, and for this sign bit, we will update it as 1. So here we will get it as 1. Why? Because sign of A is 0. For sign of A is 0, we will set it as 1. This is our step number 3. Then again, one more step is remaining for n iteration, for 4 iteration. Again, we will check that sign of A is 0. So sign of A is 0, the steps are shaped. Here, subtract and set Q0. Shift, subtract and set Q0. So we will perform this step here. So shift it, empty. Then 1, 0, 0, this 0 will be LSB, 1 and 3 times 0. This is our new A value and new Q value. We have to set this empty space. So first we will perform subtraction. For subtraction, 2's complement is 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. Perform addition of 2's complement. 1, 1, 1, 5 times 1, we will get the addition. Again, we will set the Q value. So all boxes means all values will be updated here. 1. And for this sign bit, we will set it as 0. So we got this Q value and we have completed our iteration number 4. Iteration number 4 we have completed here. So in our algorithm, we have performed this n step, do n times A and B. We have checked the sign bit, we have completed this step also, we have set the Q0 bit, A minus M, A plus M, and then we have set this Q0 bit. That means we have completed this N iteration. So after completing this N iteration, we will perform step number 2. What is step number 2? We will check the sign bit. If sign bit is 1, then we will add M to A. That is A equals to A plus M. So here we will add this A equals to A plus M if sign of A is 1. Here we got sign of A as 1. So we have to restore this. If by chance if we get sign of A as 0, so we will keep it as it is. We will not update this result. But here we got it as 1, so we have to update this result. We will perform this updation. For performing updation, I will rewrite A here. So A equals to 5 times 1 we got. Then A plus M we have to perform. So M equals to 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. Perform addition. 1, 1, 0, carry 1, 1, carry 1, 0, carry 1, 0, carry 1, 0. And carry 1 we will discard. So what result we got after updation in A is 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. And we got Q as here. Q is 0, 0, 1, 0. 0, 0, 1, 0. So we can neglect this last bit as we have added it in first step for performing this algorithm. So we will neglect this last bit. What result we got? In A, 0, 0, 1, 0 and Q, 0, 0, 1, 0. Hence A is remainder. We have discussed this, that we will consider A as remainder and Q as quotient. In previous video, we have discussed about this. A is remainder and Q is quotient. So this is 4-bit remainder and this is Q is 4-bit quotient. Thank you, friends.